In this video, we'll look at the different methods for placing walls near, under, adjacent, and partially exposed to the stairs. Let's begin with a fully enclosed stairwell. In this sample room with an existing set of stairs, I'll use the interior wall tool and create a wall parallel to the stairs and then snap it to the stair. With the wall on the outside of the stairs, an enclosed stairwell is created. To place the wall underneath the stairs, I'm going to click on the wall in the floor plan view. I'm going to use my arrow keys and nudge it underneath of the stairs. You're going to notice that the wall is exposed at the very end. A good practice is to pull the wall back past so the first tread is exposed, and then you have the wall that will be cut by the stairs as long as it is underneath of the stairs. In the next scenario, to create a stair rake wall railing, I'm going to go ahead and click on the wall in the floor plan view. There may be times when the wall is underneath the stairs. Notice where I clicked and my cursor is. I'm going to press the tab key to go to the next closest object. The wall is now selected. I'm going to pull it out from underneath of the stairs, and then I'll rebump it on the outside. Then I'm going to take the very end of this wall, and I'm going to pull it back to 5 or 6 different treads. You now see an exposed set of stairs. For the rake wall condition, I'm going to use the straight half wall. I'm going to come over, snap onto the end of the wall. I'm going to pull it to the end of the stairs. Then I'll go ahead and press escape to get out of the selection mode. I'm going to double click on the wall to open up the wall properties. A rake wall in Chief Architect is known as two different wall types. It's also called a pony wall inside of our program. On the wall types panel, I'm going to come down and mark the indication for the pony wall. On the elevation for the lower wall, I'm going to change that to be 12 inches. For the upper wall type, I'm going to change the upper wall type to be an interior railing wall type. On the rail style panel, I'm going to change this to be balusters. And as a preference, you could remove the bottom rail and then also have the balusters go all the way to the bottom, and you can create a stair rake wall using those steps. In the last option for your walls is to have a partially exposed railing. I'm going to delete the wall that was just created. I'm going to go ahead and pull the existing wall just a few more treads, and then I want to have the stairs, as we zoom in, expand so that they dead end into the wall. I'm going to click on the stairs, and in the bottom edit menu you're going to find a break tool. Then I want to actually create a complete break, which will generate actually 2 stair segments. Using the complete break tool, I'm going to come up that intersection and I'm going to click to create a complete break. Then I'm going to click on the bottom stair segment. Notice there's only one move handle. Using the complete break, I actually have 2 different sets of stairs. I'll then just go ahead and pull that out so that the stair snaps to the outside wall. And then one feature I like to do, let's double click and open up the stairs. On the style panel, there is an option to uncheck open underneath. That way you'll get an enclosure right in that area for the stairs. That wraps up this video on placing walls with stairs.